Probably I don't need to tell you what the memory card is and how it is used, but what might be of interest for you though is how a memory card could be used together with the AC500 PLC. There are many things which could be done with the memory card from user application, like data logging, recipe reading, writing or reading of random files for whatever reason you might need it in your application. But let's leave it aside for now. That's a pretty big topic, but for future episodes. What I wanted to show you today are available automatic operations with specifically prepared files on a memory card. We're talking about two things here. User application update, sometimes we call it boot project, and PLC firmware update. For this operation, we would need any memory card available in PLC automation catalog and automation builder software. As usual, Yuri here. Let's start the show. Okay, for starter, we need to have our project created with all the hardware we intend to use in actual installation. The CPU itself, all I/O modules, communication modules, option boards in case of Eco PLC. If we want to update user application along with the firmware, we obviously need to have all POUs ready as well. In other words, project must be compiled and ready to be loaded to a CPU. Then we go to Application, Export, select from one of two options available, boot projects and firmware or just the firmware. And the viewer with a keen eye might say, wait a minute, what if I want to update just the boot project? And that's a very good question, thanks for asking, but we'll get back to it in a minute. For now, let's pretend we want to update both, so we select the first item. Next, we must select empty folder somewhere on our PC where memory card folder structure will be created. Once the process is completed, we will get corresponding message. Next come the interesting part. If we open the folder where we told Automation Builder to save files for a memory card, we can see four main parts. Version file, which ensures firmware versions compatibility of all PLC components. Folder firmware, as the name suggests, contains firmware files of all PLC components. Along with each firmware file, there is also a signature file, which ensures that PLC could only be loaded with files signed by developers. Folder user data contains compiled user application with checksum CRC file. And finally, SDCARD.INI file gives instruction to a PLC what to do during the update process. The whole file is divided in sections, each of which starts with a keyword in square brackets. Comment lines start with semicolon symbol. Section status is the reason why we even opened this file in the first place. Parameter function of card defines the action PLC will perform during update process. Value 0, no action will be performed. Value 1, only user application or boot project will be updated. Remember I told you we'll come back to this topic. That's actually how you do it, but please be careful. If existing PLC firmware is older than what requires loaded user application, you may run into problems when PLC will not start. In other words, know what you're doing before you do it. Back to values. Value 2, only firmware components will be updated. And finally, value 3, two previous options combined. And at this point, we could have wrapped everything up, put memory card into PLC and enjoy the result, except one thing. If we carefully examine Automation Builder help system. By the way, did you know that since Automation Builder 2.7, the whole help system is available in web browser? I find it really convenient. I'll leave the link in the description below. Check it out. So As I was saying, if we carefully read help section dedicated to memory card, we will find out that after update operation, PLC expects us to remove memory card and manually power cycle. So what? What's the big deal, you might say? And in many cases it's not, but in some, there's simply no possibility to perform required action. Thankfully, with the release of firmware 2.7, we have additional tools to tackle this problem. Values 4, 5, and 6 of function of card parameter will tell PLC to perform the same operation as it was with 1, 2, and 3, but in addition, at the end of the process, PLC will reboot automatically. We still have a couple more sections of SDCARD.INI file to cover. Firmware update section defines how exactly specific firmware component will be updated. For example, parameter CPU FW has value 11, which means that CPU firmware will be updated regardless of version of existing firmware. On the other hand, parameter display FW has value 12, and in this case, before updating, PLC will check if version of existing display firmware is different from what we're trying to load. And if it is, then update will be performed. There's also value 13, which means the only newer than existing firmware will be updated. The same applies to the user proc section. The only difference is that user program parameter covers how to update user application. And finally, there are sections like CPU, coupler, OB module, which specify where, related to SDCARD.INI file, firmware files of various PLC components are located. Now we can close the file, select and copy all files and folders in the same level as SDCARD.INI, and paste them to the root folder of the memory card. Once that is finished, we take the memory card to PLC, put it in, and turn the power on. The update process will start. Once it is done, CPU will either ask for manual reboot and memory card removal, or if we specified value 4, 5, or 6 for function of card parameter, will reboot automatically. After update process is finished, in the root folder of memory card, PLC will create SDCARD.RDY file, which is basically log file of update operations. You might want to examine it and check which components were updated, which were not, and what's the reason. I know it might look a bit intimidating, all these INI files, parameters, values, but in 99% of cases, you don't even need to open that file. Everything can be handled by Automation Builder and File Explorer. We just wanted to show you what is possible. Alright, that's all for today. We hope that was useful and helps you keep automating. Have a lovely day, wherever you are.